best of the mages are ready, Herald. Be certain you are prepared for the assault on the breach. We cannot know how you will be affected.
Focus past the Herald. Let his will draw from you.
Did it. Solas confirms the heavens are scarred but calm. The breach is sealed. We've reports of lingering rifts, and many questions remain. But this was a victory. Word of your heroism has spread.
You know how many were involved. Luck put me at the center.
A strange kind of luck. I'm not sure if we need more or less. But you're right. This was a victory of Alliance. One of the few in recent memory. With the breach closed, that alliance will need new focus.
Forces approaching! To arms!
What the? We must get to the gates! Cullen?
One watch guard reporting. It's a massive force, the bulk over the mountain.
Under what banner?
None.
None?
I can't come in unless you open.
I'm Cole. I came to warn you, to help. People are coming to hurt you. You probably already know.
What is this? What's going on?
The Templars come to kill you.
Templars? Is this the Order's response to our talks with the mages, attacking blindly?
The Red Templars went to the Elder One. You know him? He knows you. You took his mages.
There.
I know that man. But this Elder One.
He's very angry that you took his mages.
Cullen, give me a plan. Anything.
Haven is no fortress. If we are to withstand this monster, we must control the battle. Get out there and hit that force. Use everything you can.
Mages! You! You have sanction to engage them. That is Samson. He will not make it easy. Inquisition! With the Herald! For your lives! For all of us!
Thank you. just messed up!
Everyone to the gates!
Move it! Move it! We need everyone back to the Chantry. It's the only building that might hold against that beast. At this point, just make them work for it.
Move! Keep going! The Chantry is your shelter!
He tried to stop a Templar. The blade went deep. He's going to die.
What a charming boy.
Harold, our position is not good. That dragon stole back any time you might have earned us.
I've seen an archdemon. I was in the Fade, but it looked like that.
I don't care what it looks like. It's cut a path for that army. They'll kill everyone in Haven.
The Elder One doesn't care about the village. He only wants the Herald.
If you know why he wants me, just say it.
I don't. He's too loud. It hurts to hear him. He wants to kill you. No one else matters, but he'll crush them, kill them anyway. I don't like him.
You don't like... Herald. There are no tactics to make this survivable. The only thing that slowed them was the avalanche. We could turn the remaining trebuchets, cause one last slide.
We're overrun. To hit the enemy, we'd bury Haven.
We're dying, but we can decide how. Many don't get that choice.
Yes, that. Chancellor Roderick can help. He wants to say it before he dies.
There is a path. You wouldn't know it unless you'd made the summer pilgrimage, as I have. The people can escape. She must have shown me. Andraste must have shown me so I could tell you.
What are you on about, Roderick?
It was whim that I walked the path. I did not mean to start. It was overgrown. Now, with so many in the Conclave dead, to be the only one who remembers... I don't know, Harold. If this simple memory can save us, this could be more than mere accident. You could be more.
If that thing is here for me, I'll make him fight for it.
And when the mountain falls, what about you? Perhaps you will surprise it. Find a way. Inquisition, follow Chancellor Roderick through the Chantry. Move!
Harold, if you are meant for this, if the Inquisition is meant for this, I pray for you.
They'll load the trebuchets. Keep the Elder One's attention until we're above the tree line. If we are to have a chance, if you are to have a chance, let that thing hear you.
I understand the strategy, but I usually avoid drawing this much attention. I suggest we aim this machine as quickly as possible.
Now!
Mm-hmm.
enough! Pretender, you toy with forces beyond your ken no more.
What are you? Why are you doing this?
Mortals beg for truth they cannot have. It is beyond what you are, what I was. Know me. Know what you have pretended to be. Exalt the Elder One. The will that is Corypheus. You will kneel.
You're forcing this fight for no reason.
You will resist. You will always resist. It matters not. I am here for the anchor. The process of removing it begins now. It is your fault, Herald. You interrupted a ritual years in the planning, and instead of dying, you stole its purpose. I do not know how you survived, but what marks you as touched, what you flail at rifts, I crafted to assault the very heavens. And you used the anchor to undo my work. The gall.
What is this thing meant to do?
It is meant to bring certainty where there is none. For you, the certainty that I would always come for it. I once breached the Fade in the name of another to serve the old gods of the Empire in person. I found only chaos and corruption, dead whispers. For 1,000 years I was confused, no more. I have gathered the will to return under no name but my own, to champion Withered Tevinter and correct this blighted world. Beg that I succeed, for I have seen the throne of the gods, and it was empty. The anchor is permanent. You have spoilt it with your stumbling. So be it. I will begin again. Find another way to give this world the nation and God it requires. And you, I will not suffer even an unknowing rival. You must die.
Your arrogance blinds you. Good to know. If I'm dying, it's not today!
Maker.
What would you have me tell them? This isn't what we asked them to do.
We cannot simply ignore this. We must find a way.
And who put you in charge? We need a consensus or we have nothing.
Please, we must use reason. Without the infrastructure of the Inquisition, we're hobbled.
I can't come from nowhere.
She didn't say it could.
Enough! This is getting us nowhere.
Well, we're agreed on that much.
Shh. You need rest.
They've been at it for hours.
They have that luxury thanks to you. The enemy could not follow, and with time to doubt, we turn to blame. Infighting may threaten as much as this Corypheus.
Do we know where Corypheus and his forces are?
We are not sure where we are, which may be why, despite the numbers he still commands, there is no sign of him. That, or you are believed dead. Or without Haven, we are thought helpless. Or he girds for another attack. I cannot claim to know the mind of that creature, only his effect on us.
If that thing is still out there, we need to move.
They are uncertain where. And there are other questions about you. Our leaders struggle because of what we survivors witnessed. We saw our defender stand and fall. And now we have seen him return. The more the enemy is beyond us, the more miraculous your actions appear, and the more our trials seem ordained. That is hard to accept, no? What we have been called to endure? What we perhaps must come to believe?
I escaped the avalanche. Barely, perhaps, but I didn't die.
Of course. And the dead cannot return from across the veil. But the people know what they saw. Or perhaps what they needed to see. The Maker works both in the moment and in how it is remembered. Can we truly know the heavens are not with us?
You saw Corypheus. What do you think of his claims of assaulting the heavens?
Scripture says magisters, Tevinter servants of false-old gods, entered the Fade to reach the Golden City, seat of the Maker. For their crime, they were cast out as darkspawn. Their hubris is why we suffer blight, and why the Maker turned from us. If such is the claim of this Corypheus, he is a monster beyond imagining. All mankind continues to suffer for that sin. If even a shred of it is true, all the more reason Andraste would choose someone to rise against him.
Corypheus said he found only corruption and emptiness, nothing golden.
If he entered that place, it has changed him without and within. The living are not meant to make that journey. Perhaps these are lies he must tell himself, rather than accept that he earned the scorn of the Maker. I know I could not bear such.
Mother Giselle, I just don't see how what I believe matters. Lies or not, Corypheus is a real physical threat. You can't match that with hope alone.
steal your heart. The dawn will come. The night is long and the path is dark. Look to the sky, for one day soon the dawn will come. The shepherd's lost and his home is far. Keep to the stars, the dawn will come. The night is long
and the path is dark.
Look to the sky. An army needs more than an enemy. It needs a cause.
A word. A wise woman, worth heeding. Her kind understand the moments that unify a cause, or fracture it. The orb Corypheus carried, the power he used against you, it is Elven. Corypheus used the orb to open the breach. Unlocking it must have caused the explosion that destroyed the Conclave. I do not yet know how Corypheus survived, nor am I certain how people will react when they learn of the orb's origin.
All right. What is it and how do you know about it?
They were foci. Used to channel ancient magics. I have seen such things in the Fade, old memories of older magic. Corypheus may think it, Devinter. His empire's magic was built on the bones of my people. Knowing or not, he risks our alliance. I cannot allow it.
This whole mess is confusing. I can see how elves might be an easy target.
History would agree, but there are steps we can take to prevent such a distraction. By attacking the Inquisition, Corypheus has changed it. Changed you. Scout to the north. Be their guide. There is a place that waits for a force to hold it. There is a place where the Inquisition can build, grow. We'll be right back.
They arrive daily from every settlement in the region. Skyhold is becoming a pilgrimage. If word has reached these people, it will have reached the Elder One. We have the walls and numbers to put up a fight here, but this threat is far beyond the war we anticipated. But we now know what allowed you to stand against Corypheus, what drew him to you.
He came for this, and now it's useless to him. So he wants me dead. That's it.
The Anchor has power, but it's not why you're still standing here. Your decisions let us heal the sky. Your determination brought us out of Haven. You are the creature's rival because of what you did. And we know it. All of us. The Inquisition requires a leader. The one who has already been leading it. You.
Perhaps I didn't hear you correctly. A mage at the head of the Inquisition.
Not a mage. You.
I happen to be a mage.
I will not pretend no one will object, but times are changing. Perhaps this is what the Maker intended. There would be no Inquisition without you. How it will serve, how you lead, that must be yours to decide.
With fear running rampant, they need to see a mage standing for what is right. I'll defeat Corypheus standing with them, not over them.
Wherever you lead us.
Have our people been told?
They have. And soon, the world.
Commander, will they follow?
Inquisition, will you follow? Will you fight? Will we triumph? Your leader, your herald, your Inquisitor!
So this is where it begins.
It began in the courtyard. This is where we turned that promise into action.
But what do we do? We know nothing about this Corypheus except that he wanted your mark.
Corypheus wants to restore Tevinter. Is this a prelude to war with the Imperium?
I get the feeling we're dealing with extremists, not the vanguard of a true invasion.
Tevinter is not the Imperium of 1,000 years ago. What Corypheus yearns to restore no longer exists.
Though they would shed no tears if the South fell to chaos, I'm certain.
Corypheus said he wanted to enter the Black City, but this would make him a god.
He is willing to tear this world apart to reach the next. It won't matter if he's wrong.
What if he's not wrong? If he finds some other way into the Fade?
Then he gains the power he seeks, or unleashes catastrophe on us all.
Could his dragon really be an archdemon? What would that mean?
It would mean the beginning of another blight.
We've seen no darkspawn other than Corypheus himself. Perhaps it's not an archdemon at all, but something different?
Whatever it is, it's dangerous. Commanding such a creature gives Corypheus an advantage we can't ignore.
Someone out there must know something about Corypheus.
Unless they saw him on the field, most will not believe he even exists.
We do have one advantage. We know what Corypheus intends to do next. In that strange future you experienced, Empress Selene had been assassinated.
Imagine the chaos her death would cause. With his army.
An army he'll bolster with a massive force of demons, or so the future tells us.
Corypheus could conquer the entire south of Thedas, god or no god.
I'd feel better if we knew more about what we were dealing with.
I know someone who can help with that. Everyone acting all inspirational jogged my memory, so I sent a message to an old friend. He's crossed paths with Corypheus before and may know more about what he's doing. He can help.
I'm always looking for new allies. Introduce me.
Parading around might cause a fuss. It's better for you to meet privately, on the battlements. Trust me, it's complicated.
Well, then, we stand ready to move on both of these concerns.
On your order, Inquisitor.
I know one thing. If Varric has brought who I think he has, Cassandra is going to kill him.
Inquisitor, meet Hawk, the champion of Kirkwall.
Though I don't use that title much anymore.
Hawk, the Inquisitor. I figured you might have some friendly advice about Corypheus. You and I did fight him, after all.
This view reminds me of my home in Kirkwall. I had a balcony that overlooked the whole city. I loved it at first, but after a while, all I could see were the people out there depending on me.
You're lucky it was just a single city. I've got half of Thedas.
You're doing everything you can to protect them.
Does it ever get any easier?
I'll let you know. I don't envy you, Inquisitor, but I may be able to help you.
Varric said that you fought Corypheus before.
Fought and killed. The Grey Wardens were holding him, and he somehow used his connection to the Darkspawn to influence them.
Corypheus got into their heads, messed with their minds, turned them against each other.
If the Wardens have disappeared, they could have fallen under his control again.
If that's what happened to the Wardens, do you think we can free them?
It's possible. But we need to know more first. I've got a friend in the Wardens. He was investigating something unrelated for me. His name is Stroud. The last time we spoke, he was worried about corruption in the Warden ranks. Since then, nothing.
Corypheus would certainly qualify as corruption in the ranks. Did your friend disappear with them?
No. He told me he'd be hiding in an old smuggler's cave near Crestwood.
If you didn't know about Corypheus, what were you doing with the Wardens?
The Templars in Kirkwall were using a strange form of lyrium. It was red. I'd hoped the Wardens could tell me more about it.
Corypheus had Templars with him at Haven. They looked like they'd been exposed to the lyrium you describe.
Hopefully my friend in the Wardens will know more.
I appreciate the help.
I'm doing this as much for myself as for you. Corypheus is my responsibility. I thought I'd killed him before. This time, I'll make sure of it.
You knew where Hawk was all along!
You're damned right I did.
You conniving little shit!
You kidnapped me! You interrogated me! What did you expect?
Hey! Enough!
You're taking his side?
I said enough!
We needed someone to lead this Inquisition. First, Liliana and I searched for the hero of Ferelden, but she had vanished. Then we looked for Hawk, but he was gone too. We thought it all connected, but no. It was just you. You kept him from us.
The Inquisition has a leader.
Hawk would have been at the Conclave if anyone could have saved Most Holy...
You can't change the past, Cassandra.
So I must accept... what? That the Maker wanted all this to happen? That he... Varric is a liar, Inquisitor. A snake. Even after the Conclave, when we needed Hawk most, Varric kept him secret.
He's with us now. We're on the same side.
We all know whose side you're on, Varric. It will never be the Inquisition's.
Attacking him now won't help us, Cassandra.
Ha! Exactly!
And you better not be keeping anything else from us.
Duh. I understand.
I must not think of what could have been. We have so much at stake. Go, Varric. Just go.
You know what I think? If Hawk had been at the temple, he'd be dead too. You people have done enough to him.
I believed him. He spun his story for me and I swallowed it. If I'd just explained what was at stake, if I'd just made him understand... But I didn't, did I? I didn't explain why we needed Hawk. I'm such a fool.
What if you hadn't believed him, and you'd tracked Hawk down?
Honestly, Hawk might not even have agreed to become Inquisitor. He supported the Mage Rebellion, after all. He wouldn't have trusted me for a second. But this isn't about Hawk, or even Varric. Not truly. I should have been more careful. I should have been smarter. I don't deserve to be here.
Have you looked at our Inquisition, Cassandra? We're all fools here.
Is that supposed to make me feel better?
More at home, maybe.
I want you to know, I have no regrets. Maybe if we'd found Hawk or the hero of Ferelden, the Maker wouldn't have needed to send you. But he did. You're not what I'd pictured. But if I've learned anything, it's that I know less than nothing.
That got a little... heated. Are you all right?
Well, that depends. How angry is Cassandra? I wasn't trying to keep secrets. I told the Inquisition everything that seemed important at the time.
I know, Varric. You never would have kept quiet otherwise.
I keep hoping none of this is real. Maybe it's all some bullshit from the Fade and it'll just disappear. I know I need to do better. I'm sorry.
Maker, you're a mess. Let me have a look at you. Are you all right, my dear? Were you hurt? You look dreadful.
You should have seen me an hour ago.
We should do something about this dirt. We don't need you frightening the faithful. Let's keep up appearances. You've handled this crisis competently, saving as many lives as you did. But the enemy struck a serious blow against you and the Inquisition. We must recognize that. You must.
I'm not going to forgive what happened at Haven. Corypheus will answer for what he's done.
You're angry. Good. Anger can save you when everything else is gone. Just make sure you put it to good use. Our enemy advances, Inquisitor. We must not sit idly by. Act first, and teach them to fear us. I think you know what needs to be done, my dear.
So, Inquisitor. It's Inquisitor now, right? Remember that war we talked about stopping? Full of little baddies I can stick with little arrows. That's not a friggin' archdemon, is it? Draste, what do I step in?
Let me know what she says. I could use some clarification myself.
It's swearing, not praying. She doesn't answer. Not like she's supposed to. I know what happened to you, or what everyone here thinks happened. It seems... I don't know what it seems.
I can't help if you don't explain what's wrong exactly.
It's got to be nonsense, doesn't it? What kind of screwed if it isn't? I mean, that Corifi thing. A magister, right? Story is, he cracked the Golden City. But that's a hazy dream. If not, seat of the Maker, real thing. A seat needs a butt, so the Maker, real thing. Fairy stories about the start and end of the world, real things. It's too far, isn't it? I just want to plug the Skyhole rubbish so I can go play.
Keep calling it nonsense. That perspective will keep the Inquisition grounded.
Oh, I can do that. Sure could use a few more people shouting no. We fight, the bad things go away, everyone calms down, and everything goes back to normal. A nice, well-paid normal.
You're starting to not sound completely crazy.
I know, scary, isn't it? So bring 'em on. But first, food. I'm starving.
So, this is Skyhold. Come, let's walk the ramparts. I want to examine our fortifications. We'll be able to see Corypheus coming from miles away.
He's not going to get the better of us again.
We lost good soldiers that day, loyal men and women. Let him come. I swear I'll take the Twister bastard down. Even if I have to die to do it.
I'm grateful for your support.
It's my job, isn't it? Killing Darkspawn. Look, in spite of it all, there is hope. The people flock to your banner. They believe in you. Tell me honestly, are you what they say you are? Andraste's chosen.
There's so little I remember. What if they're right?
Does it even matter? Don't you see what you are to them? Without you, they'd be consumed by despair. We all would. They need you to be Andraste's messenger. It gives them hope. The truth doesn't matter. Listen to me talk. Your time is valuable, and I've wasted enough of it.
Inquisitor, huh? Well, you've got the fortress for it. Speaking of which, when you've got a second, there's something I want to show you.
What did you want me to come see?
Here, come on. I'll show you.
Why am I dressed like this?
You'll see. Come on. It'll be worth your time, I promise. Evening. Iron Bull. My merc band just joined up.
Tanner. I'm from Jader. Well, Mir Jader.
Mira. I was guard captain for Lady Pendel. Signed on after shit blew up at the Conclave. Share a drink? Who's your friend?
This is Grim. He doesn't talk much. So, you ready to kill some demons? Or Venatori, or whatever that Corypheus asshole is?
This isn't just about killing. We're helping the Inquisitor save the world and build the next empire.
The Inquisitor isn't a god. He's just a man trying to do the right thing.
Well, long as I get paid, I'm happy. That's why I signed up.
I just couldn't spend my whole life on a farm. Needed to live a little, you know.
What about you, Mira? Why'd you join up? I thought you were serving some noble.
I saw what happened at Haven. The Inquisitor staring down that monster and his archdemon. I don't sing the chant of light as much as I should. But you can't see something like that and not believe.
Well, Grim and I should find our tents. Thanks for the drink.
I know every soldier under my command. You don't have that option, but a few faces might help.
You made it sound like you didn't like the Inquisition.
People don't always tell the truth when you're polite. You've got to poke them a bit.
It was good to get their perspective.
Yeah. Sounds like we could use an easy win for boys like Tanner. And vets like Mira have seen enough to be wary. You've got a good army coming along. Remember that. No matter what comes next.
Send men to scout the area. We need to know what's out there.
Yes, sir.
Commander, soldiers have been assigned temporary quarters.
Very good. I'll need an update on the armory as well. Now! We set up as best we could at Haven, but could never prepare for an archdemon, or whatever it was. With some warning, we might have...
We were all shaken by what happened.
If Corypheus strikes again, we may not be able to withdraw. And I wouldn't want to. We must be ready. Work on Skyhold is underway. Guard rotations established. We should have everything on course within the week. We will not run from here, Inquisitor.
How many were lost?
Most of our people made it to Skyhold. It could have been worse. Morale was low, but it's improved greatly since you accepted the role of Inquisitor.
Everyone has so much faith in my leadership. I hope I'm ready.
You won't have to carry the Inquisition alone, although it must feel like it. We needed a leader, and you have proven yourself.
You responded quickly to the attack on Haven. Without that, so many more would have died. I'm grateful for any help you can give.
Thank you, Inquisitor. I will do everything I can to ensure the security of our people. You have my word.
This thing is not a stray puppy you can make into a pet. It has no business being here.
Wouldn't you say the same of an apostate?
Inquisitor, I wondered if Cole was perhaps a mage, given his unusual abilities.
He can cause people to forget him, or even fail entirely to notice him. These are not the abilities of a mage. It seems that Cole is a spirit.
It is a demon.
If you prefer, although the truth is somewhat more complex.
I'm not sure how much more complexity I need, Solas.
Indeed, my dear. He may call it whatever he likes, but it is still a threat.
In fact, his nature is not so easily defined.
Speak plainly, Solas. What are we dealing with?
Demons normally enter this world by possessing something. In their true form, they look bizarre, monstrous.
But you claim Cole looks like a young man. Is it possession?
No. He has possessed nothing and no one. And yet he appears human in all respects. Cole is unique, Inquisitor. More than that, he wishes to help. I suggest you allow him to do so.
In my studies, demons either possessed something from this world or were summoned and bound. They almost never look like something you'd mistake for a person.
Normally you'd be correct. But Cole has willfully manifested in human form without possessing anyone.
The demons who came through the breach, or through the rifts, weren't possessing anything.
These demons were drawn through against their will, driven mad by this world. But Cole predates the breach. From what we can tell, he has lived here for months, perhaps years. He looks like a young man. For all intents and purposes, he is a young man. It is remarkable.
I should hear what Cole has to say for himself. Where is he now?
If none of us remember him, he could be anywhere.
Haven. So many soldiers fought to protect the pilgrims so they could escape. Choking fear. Can't think from the medicine, but the cuts rack me with every heartbeat. Hot, white pain. Everything burns. I can't. I'm dying. I'm
dead.
You're feeling their pain.
It's louder this close, with so many of them.
Would you like to go somewhere more comfortable?
Yes, but here is where I can help. Every breath slower, like lying in a warm bath, sliding away. Smell of my daughter's hair when I kiss her goodnight.
Gone.
Cracked brown pain, dry, scraping, thirsty. Here.
Thank you.
It's all right. She won't remember me.
Solas tried to explain what you are, but honestly, I stopped listening after a while. Any chance you could explain it?
Yes. I used to think I was a ghost. I didn't know. I made mistakes, but I made friends, too. Then a Templar proved I wasn't real. I lost my friends. I lost everything. I learned how to be more like what I am. It made me different, but stronger. I can feel more. I can help.
If you're willing, the Inquisition could use your help.
Yes, helping. I help the hurt, the helpless. There's someone. Hurts. It hurts. It hurts. Someone make it stop hurting. Make her, please. The healers have done all they can. It will take him hours to die. Every moment will be agony. He wants mercy. Help.
All right. Help him.
It's all right. I want to stay.
Brilliant, isn't it? One moment you're trying to restore order in a world gone mad. That should be enough for anyone to handle, yes? Then, out of nowhere, an archdemon appears and kicks you in the head. What? You thought this would be easy? No, I was just hoping you wouldn't crush our village like an anthill. Sorry about that. Archdemons like to crush, you know. Can't be helped. Am I speaking too quickly for you?
You don't need to worry about me. I can keep up.
Yes, I noticed that.
Did you now?
Certainly. If you were a slack-jawed yokel, you'd already be dead. I always assumed the Elder One behind the Venatori was a magister. But this is something else completely. In Tevinter, they say the Chantry's tales of magisters starting the Blight are just that. Tales. But here we are. One of those very magisters. A dark spawn.
Who does the Imperium say started the Blight?
You know how it is. Not us. They say dark spawn were always there. Magisters and the Blight aren't even related. Is that a surprise? No one wants to admit they shit the bed. But if Corypheus is one of the magisters who entered the Black City and he's dark spawn, what other explanation is there?
We only know what Corypheus claims to be.
True. He might be a convincing liar, or delusional, or insane. But how many delusional maniacs are going to have that knowledge? He broke open the Fade. I knew what I was taught couldn't be the whole truth, But I assumed there had to be a kernel of it, somewhere. But no, it was us all along. We destroyed the world.
Last I checked, the Blights hadn't actually destroyed the world.
Not for lack of trying. If they were more clever, they'd have unleashed something that would really do the job. No one will thank me, whatever happens. No one will thank you either. You know that, yes?
That's not why I'm doing this.
I knew there was something clever about you. All I know is this. Corypheus needs to be stopped. Men like him ruined my homeland. I won't stand by and let him ruin the world. Oh, and congratulations on that whole leading the Inquisition thing, by the way.
I'm sorry.
So am I.
The names of those we lost. You must blame me for this.
We all saw who attacked us. We know exactly who to blame.
I keep wondering if I could have done something different. When the first of my lookouts went missing, I pulled the rest back, awaiting more information. If they'd stayed in the field, they could have bought us more time. I was afraid to lose my agents. And instead, we lost Haven.
You look out for your people. That's a good thing.
Is it? My people know their duty. They know the risks. They understand that the Inquisition may call upon them to give their lives.
Our people aren't tools to be used and discarded. Your instincts were right. Their lives matter.
Can we afford such sentimentality? What if Corypheus?
We are better than Corypheus.